Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new to this channel, then why not subscribe my channel for more videos like this? And I hope you subscribe my channel, guys. So moving on, the main topic you want to see today is about YES Bank Limited. So guys, what is so special about YES Bank Limited? The quarter third results is going to come for YES Bank. As you can see here, this is a shareholding pattern of the public shareholders. As you know, which shareholding pattern for with is very very important for a company. Shareholding pattern defines the big investors who have invested and how much is a retail investor they have invested. Big companies do not invest in this type of shares without a reason. They invest for a reason and they expect a return from these shares. So keeping that point away, now let us see who are the big investors. The first comes the institution under mutual funds. In mutual funds, HDFC is the largest holder of 2.27% stake. They are holding 5,078 lakh shares in this, guys. And if we come to foreign portfolio investors, 238% have been invested in this company. So it is nearly around 15% of total stake in YES Bank. Out of 100%, foreign portfolio investors are holding 15.17% stake. That means 38 crore shares they have been holding. In which government pension fund is very very important company to note, and Vanguard means it is a big investment company in USA which is known for its beautiful investments in many other sectors. Moving on, Life Insurance Corporation of India holds around 8.06%, the single stakeholder of a major portion of this YES Bank is Life Insurance Corporation. 8% is being owned by LIC, guys. As you can see here, any other qualified institutional buyers, yes guys, recently they have the QAP which was placed at 83 rupees. But moving on, as you can see here, individual shareholders, as you can see here, 16 lakh shareholders, I mean the individual shareholders like us, there are 16,18,325 shareholders holding it, which means 43.66% stake, which means our individual shareholders is controlling the price movement of YES Bank, which is very very important to note it, guys. But a point comes here, where is Rakesh Jindal's stake? Because they want to disclose the Rakesh Jindal's stake, but it did not disclose. So what is the main reason for Rakesh Jindal's stake did not disclose in this shareholding pattern? Because recently only Rakesh Jindal bought the stocks of YES Bank. So now, why is this person's name is not available? Maybe I don't know why the reason they have not given this specifically, guys. And also moving, which remaining all is not a matter, but Rakesh Jindal's shareholding percentage is not given the shareholding pattern. That's what make me like confusing, because once they should put this name, because they have bought a large amount of stake, I mean 0.5%. As you can see here, for financial institutions or banks, they did not disclose as they bought only 0.42%. Maybe because of that reason, because it does not touch 1%, so they have not disclosed his name, I think so, guys. Other than this, they will surely disclose. That was the reason they did disclose Rakesh Jindal's name. But amount of shares he bought is around 1 crore shares, I think so, guys. So I hope this news helps you a lot. If this news helps you a lot, then why not help us by subscribing to our channel and sharing this video to your friends, so that all could get knowledge about the shareholding pattern of YES Bank. See you in another video soon. Until then, bye from our channel, guys.